Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how to use the built-in authenticator in Safari. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So with Safari version 15 in both Big Sur and Monterey, you can now have authentication codes automatically filled in. These are also known as two-factor codes or verification codes. So if you go to Safari, Preferences, and then to Passwords, you'll see all the passwords you have saved here. So when you go to log into these sites, you can automatically have the ID and password filled in by Safari. This allows you to use really strong passwords since you don't have to type them every time. But most sites also now have two-factor authentication. So in addition to the password, you're going to have to enter a one-time code. Sometimes these come over SMS, and then you can automatically have those filled in using a cool feature on your Mac that does that. Other times you need to use an authentication app. For instance, Google Authenticator is a very common one. You use that to sign on to Google, but also a whole bunch of other services as well. So for a while now, password managers like 1Password have allowed you to get these authentication codes. But now Safari does as well. So Safari can not only fill in your ID and password, but also the current one-time verification code. Let's look at how to set that up. So as an example, I'm going to use a Google account. So I've got my demo Google account selected here, and now I could go to Edit to take a look at it. So here I can see the username and the password and also the website at the bottom. I can also add the verification code here. Now of course verification codes only exist for a temporary period of time, usually about 30 seconds or 1 minute. They change all the time. So what this is actually going to do is allow Safari to hook into the system that generates these codes so it can give you the current code. When you click Enter Setup Key, you go to this screen and you're asked to enter this setup key. Now to get that setup key, you have to go back to the site that you're using. So in this case, Google. So let's take a look at what to do in Google to get the setup key. So here I am in Google and I'm logged in to my account. If I click on that, I can go to Manage Google Account. And then if I go to Security, I can go down to Two-Step Verification and you can see it's turned on. So once I'm in Two-Step Verification, I can either turn it on, in which case I will get this code that I need, or I could change it. So I'm going to change right here and I'm going to select iPhone, Next, and you can see it says Setup Authenticator and it gives you this QR code that you could scan using the Google Authenticator app. But if you click on Can't Scan It, then you'll see you get this key. So in this case it's this. I will select it and copy. And then I'm going to go back into Safari Preferences and then click Edit, Enter Setup Key, paste it in there, and click OK. And now I can see this code. So I have to use that to verify. So I'll go to Next, enter it in, verify, and now you can see I've got it all done. So now if I go and sign out of Google and I want to sign in again, it's going to ask me for my password. And I could click here and select the password and go to Next. Now it's going to ask me for the verification code. When I click here, you can see it allows me to fill that in and it grabs the current one. And now I could log in without having to go to the Google Authenticator app on my phone or use another app like Authy or a password manager like 1Password to get that code. Safari can do it for me. And better yet, it syncs over iCloud. So on my other Mac, I also can get that verification code and I could do so on my iPhone and iPad as well. So when you set up a new account, the process is pretty much the same, especially at Google, because you create your ID and your password first, and then you go in and you add two-factor authentication. Other sites are going to do it differently, so you need to look for where they provide that key for you to enter in. And not all sites are going to be compatible. Some use proprietary systems that are special apps, so you only can get that app on your phone. Others are only going to use SMS, they're just going to send you text messages. And that should automatically be filled in as long as you've turned on SMS forwarding for your iPhone to forward to your Mac. Then you should get those SMS codes on your Mac and it should recognize that and allow you to fill them in. Of course, worst case scenario is you just have to look at the message and type the code in yourself. And also, sometimes you'll go to a website and it won't allow you to fill in the code even though you have it here. You can see it when you go into Safari Preferences. In that case, You just have to go to Safari Preferences and look at it. If you click here, you can copy it so you can paste it in. But it's still better than having to launch a separate app or pull out your phone to get that code. So I've been using this for a little while and it's definitely a lot better than having to use the Google Authenticator app for so many things. I can do everything right on my Mac without having to install an additional app. And the bottom line is, if it makes using two-factor authentication easier for people, then more people will use two-factor authentication and everybody will be more secure. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.